A viewer recently asked me if there was a way they could prevent duplicate entries in a cell and limit the number of characters for the entries. So to do this, we have to apply multiple data validation rules. Because the custom data validation feature allows only a single formula to be used, we'll need to create a nested formula that will evaluate each of the criteria that we need met. So you'll want to begin by determining what you need your data validation rule to evaluate, and then use this to create the formula that you'll use. So for this example, we need our formula to evaluate for two things. First, we need to prevent duplicate entries. To do this, we'll use the COUNTIF function, selecting the cells that we want to apply the data validation rules to, and I'm going to log this by using F4. And when checking for duplicates, always select the very first cell of your range as the criteria. Then I'm going to close the parentheses, and I'm going to finish this with equals 1. This means that the result of this COUNTIF function needs to equal 1. If it's more than 1, that means we have a duplicate, and this will trigger an error alert. So we'll press enter and ignore that it says false. And actually, I'm going to move this to show formulas so we can see what we're creating. The next thing we need to evaluate for is the number of characters in a cell. So let's say we want to limit the entries to no more than 5 characters in each cell. So these can be letters, numbers, symbols, or spaces. For this, we'll use the len function. So we'll type equals len, select the first cell, close the parentheses, and then say less than 6. So here, the len function will count the number of characters in a cell, and applying less than 6 at the end will trigger an alert if 6 or more characters are entered in any of these cells. So you can continue creating more formulas if you have other criteria that you need to meet, but for this example, we're going to be stopping at 2. So next, we also need to decide if we need for all of the criteria met or just one of the criteria. So if you do not need all of them to be met, you just need at least one, then you'll want to incorporate the OR function in your nested function. But if you want all of the criteria to be met, like we do here, we'll use the AND function at the beginning. So I'll just type AND for now so we remember this. So now that we have laid out all the requirements, we can just copy and paste this into a single nested formula that will look like this. So once you've combined all your requirements into your new formula, you'll want to copy that formula, but don't paste it anywhere yet because you need to keep it in your clipboard's memory. You'll need to select all of the cells that you want to apply your data validation rule to. Then go to your data tab. In the data tools section, click to open data validation. And from this dropdown, select custom. And here, begin with the equal sign and use Control V to paste your formula. Unclick Show Formulas. Oh, and let's delete these other formulas up here. And now if you type more than 5 characters in a cell, you'll receive a data validation error, as well as if you try to type a duplicate entry. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.